Hey everybody, what's going on? Your host AMF1534 here. Let's jump on some pipes right here on Half-Life. And I tried to tell myself that I was going to take a break tonight, not film anything, maybe get some rest. But if there's one thing that I've learned about playing Half-Life twice now, is that one does not simply stay away from Half-Life for too long. We had a very interesting episode last time involving seeing all the creepy crawlies in this game, and one little bastard spawned out of the ceiling and broke my bridge. And then he died. So good. He deterred us momentarily, but I thought that I was going to get some sleep because God knows that I needed it. And so, unfortunately, it didn't last for very long because, you know, it being about 2 in the morning and one extremely long Friends marathon later, here we are. You know what, before I go down here, I think I saw a door over here, over that way, see? Let's see if we can do this without breaking all the bones in our body. God! Did it just say that it detected a fracture? I mean, for me having snapped all of the bones in my lower body, I'm actually moving around just fine. I mean, if it were me, personally, I don't think I'd be moving so much anymore. Especially considering that I have pretty shitty ankles as it is. I mean, playing a lot of basketball really didn't do me a lot of favors. What was that little move? He's like, spin move! Damn, he's actually got some pretty solid accuracy with that little acid ball of his. Got a better idea, though. I think if we're going to have to address that guy, we should probably take a different course of action here. Yeah, I think after, you know, playing enough basketball and rolling my ankles and just having flat feet, I think that I may or may not be able to survive long falls like that. Even though I don't know if it necessarily has anything to do with how strong the muscles in your legs are, or in your ankles are, for that matter. Did we get him? We did. Great. Fantastic. What the hell are those things? Oh, gross. They're like these weird alien nipples with extremely long tassels. I don't think I like that at all. There's gotta be a different way for us to traverse this murky Willamette River water. You guys aren't gonna really understand that that reference very well, but it's a river that's here in Oregon that everybody makes fun of it because it just, the water seems like it's so dirty that if anybody were to go swimming in it, they'd totally come out with like 3 heads or something. We like to call it the radioactive river. Oh damn, dude, this thing's trying to suck me in. Oh shit. Oh god. Nope. We're not gonna do that. Can we actually run up this way? God, I hope so. I think we're actually gonna be able to do that. I got a weird feeling that's not how they designed that. Like, look at the angle of that. There's no way we should be able to just sprint up that normally. Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, if he's gonna bite me and then go land in a puddle of acid, then that's his own problem. I figured there might be something over here. Hey. Anything good? Yes, there is something good here. Once again, a very, very obscure place to put one of those, but I'm not gonna complain. I'm not mad about it. Let's see what they got in store for us over here. Yet again, by the way, another busted bridge. I noticed that, but I didn't really say anything upon it. Ugh, I don't like these little enclosed areas like this. I just feel like at one point I'm going to end up seeing something that I really don't want to. And I'm kind of getting to the point where, you know, I think the last thing that I want to deal with is having, you know, some otherworldly being that wants nothing more to do with me than to ravage my body apart and then consume the remains. And then this? Like, who the hell is going to be doing this? Why is there not, like, a lever of some kind to address this for me? Like, for me, I have an absolute deathly fear of heights, so this little scenario would never be happening. I mean, I would have just mailed it in a long time ago, but Mr. Freeman, on the other hand, he's got a different plan. I mean, he has no fear whatsoever. Oh no! He should have had some of it. God! How destructive was that? It's so much worse because you can't even see the floor. Like, for anybody that has a fear of heights, that's like the ultimate bad, you know, huge heights dilemma. Like, it's bad enough that you're way up here, but you can't even see the floor. However, we got through it just fine. The second time around, after we found a way to resurrect our extremely mutilated corpse. Alright, let's check this out. Let's see what happens from here. Surprisingly, we haven't really seen very many enemies in this game. Or not in this game, but in this segment. Which, I got a feeling that's gonna change pretty quickly. I kinda went and jinxed ourselves over this whole thing. I'm hoping we can get up there. That'd be awesome if we could do that. Or we can do this. I don't think anything good's gonna come out of this. If there's anything that the game Fear taught me, or any horror game in general, is that if you go into an elevator by yourself, then the lights are gonna cut out, and then fucking all sorts of bad shit's gonna happen. It's just gonna be like, ba-boom! And the paranormal stuff cues in, and then you're fucked. That's all I gotta say about that. Oh no. Great. Dude, office segments of these games are never a good thing. Oh god! Yikes! That's like the polar opposite of the song Pull Me Under by Dream Theater. Instead of, pull me under, it's, lift me upwards! Oh, dude, why did the thing all have to spit out the remains on me? That's never good. Gah! Yikes. Okay, let's see if we can go around that by chance. Oh! Okay. Alright, well, now we know that's not a very good idea. Oh, I guess I should have gone in here. The blatantly obvious choice. God! The blatantly obvious choice of going in here instead. Right or left? Eh, we'll go left. Why not? Aw. Dude, enough of these little head crabs. These guys are little bastards. It's like, go get your own fucking body, you little douchebags. By the way, the battery on this little flashlight of ours is surprisingly really good. That was funny. He just, like, willingly committed suicide. He's like, I'm gonna get him! Got chopped into a nice little minced meat casserole. Now, there's gotta be a reason for us to have come in here. Bullets? Yes. Second thing of bullets? Yeah? Whoa. Jeez! Why are we down to 4 health? I wasn't even close to touching that thing. Alright, well, God, I'm not gonna sit here and risk it now. That, my friends, is buttery bullshit on a Popeye's biscuit, because those things are delicious, but we weren't even close to touching that thing. Fucking video game logic. Gotta be the bane of my existence again. Like, I'm not even kidding. That little head crab thing was a lot closer to that thing than I was, and mysteriously, he made it out of that thing, you know, in no worse condition. Whoa! Jeez, he just got tractor beamed up there. I'm gonna go up into heaven! Except for the fact that I'm getting eaten to death! It's actually kind of whoa! I was gonna say, it's actually kind of intriguing watching that thing feast on something until it just completely just obliterates the body. It's kind of gross. I want to blow that thing up. Aww. It's like it pooped or so. Aww, it's like pooping out parts. It's kind of disgusting. Oh, hey, there's a survivor here.
Hi, Sigourney. If I'd known it was you, I'd have let you in. Everyone's heading for the service. But I think they're crazy, not to say what. Someone is bound to come by and rescue us.
You know, I think that's probably some of the most backwards logic that I've ever seen. Did you not watch your colleague just get eaten alive? Gah! And there's more of them!
I predicted all of this, you know.
Did you really? Well, if you predicted all of it, then why didn't you stop it? Fucking idiot. Morons! I'm surrounded by morons! God, these things are everywhere, man. I mean, you have fun thinking somebody's going to come and save you. Because I'm sure that somebody that comes down here is going to be like, I got an idea. Let's go into the dilapidated fucking library office. I'll bet there's one guy in there that we can save. Yeah, right. I wonder if we can get anything out of this. Really? And it gives us one health. Awesome. Yes, give me one little... I mean, I'm not really doing my health a favor in real life, as I just ingested about 200 grams of sugar, but hey, I'm feeling good. I feel good about the whole experience. I don't want a piece of you, I want the whole thing. Ooh, this little area looks like fun. Especially when we get to do this. Yeah. Let's kind of explore other options here. Are there anywhere else we can go? Like here? Oh, jeez. What the hell's your problem? Get the fuck out of here. You got a problem with that? Oh, now he's all upset. He's like, God damn it! He hit me right in the hands! It was so mean! I was just trying to make friends. Yeah, now he's just ruining everything. He's having a little manopause attack. I love the little delayed reaction when you hit him. He's like, oh, ow! And then he falls over. He's like, oh, I think this is actually supposed to hurt. And then he finally goes down. Oh, well, that looks like a completely other experience in itself. So... Man, I see one of these little I saw one of these little things over here. I kind of want to deal with that, but at the same time, I don't. Because I don't want to get electrocuted and die. So I got an idea. We'll go check this out, and then we'll come back over that way. I mean, why ever carry a hatchet ever again? You can just use a crowbar, and it's way more effective. You know what I'm saying? It's a fantastic idea. Oh, good. It's a guy that lives. Oh my god, yes! Finally! What the hell is he shooting at?
Did you see that shot?
No, actually. What the fuck are you shooting at? Oh! Yeah!
Got one!
Really, dude? Come on. How dare you take credit for my kill?
Ooh, something died down here.
Yeah, like him. Don't you ever take credit for my kills again, or else you're next. That's all I gotta say about that. Oh, yes, health! Amazing. Where the fuck did he go? There he is. He was just floating. He just defied the laws of physics. However, he is an alien, so I think he can do that if he wants.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Sure, why not? Actually, you know what? I want to go down here and see what's up with these conspicuously placed boxes. Cool, we got a little more power for our suit. And another med kit. Yes! God, I love these things. So great. Why can't that be a thing all the time? Like, why can't we just bust open a box every single day and have it be worth something? Okay, here goes this whole thing. We can do some more classic crouch jumping. I can see that the water's also electrified, so we should probably not touch that if we don't have to. Okay, this is the jump that I was worried about. I farted. I mean, every once in a while, sometimes you just gotta push some air out of your asshole. Why not? I mean, it's a basic human function. I mean, if I gotta sit here and be my own Chevron station, then so be it, you know? No, get in there! Get in the hole! Get in the hole! God, get the fuck out of the way. Get in the hole! What are you doing? I'll have none of your sauce. Get out of the way. You can go die an early death, you fucking hockey puck. God, that was the most frustrating getting inside of a vent moment, I think. Oh, God! Oh, man, that was actually pretty funny. I'm okay with the fact that that just happened. All the frustration that I gained from that, and I just go and get my head sliced off. Firmly at the neck. And something just got killed, apparently. That was hilarious. I'm totally okay with that death. That was well worth the price of admission. Great. More? had it up to here with these guys. Oh, we got a ladder right here. Yeah, I guess we can go up with that thing. Yeah. Oh, wait, no, we can move boxes. That's right. I forgot we could do that sort of thing. The things you learn when you actually go through tutorial stages. Had I not done that, boy, I would have been probably shit up a creek. Because I would have been like, oh, I can't go through there. Maybe I'll try to go through the fucking ventilation thing that was back in that office. Hey! Oh, come on! There we go. God. I swear, sometimes it's actually quite the chore getting up some of these things. Alright. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, God, we're about to die. I didn't realize that. Please tell me there's a medkit around here somewhere. For the betterment of my life. Ooh, we got a dead guy. Oh no! Oh my God! What in the world was that? Oh God, it's a drone gun! Oh boy. Okay, so this is what's gonna happen. We're gonna stop right here, but when we come back on the next episode of Let's Play Half-Life, we got ourselves quite the adventure in store, and that adventure is called Don't Get, you know, cut into nice little pieces of cube steak by that giant-ass turd over there. So when we come back, that's what we're going to deal with. But until then, this is your host, AMF1534, saying thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.